Hello everyone, I'm Betty. The first thing I want to do is ask you guys a question. How many people have seen the killer whale shows or the show of dolphins? Many people might admire the beautiful appearance and the great learning scale. Also, they look meek and vital shimmers. It was the feeling of me when I was a child. Many people also have that feeling, so they love to watch the killer whale shows. But is this the real character the killer whales have in the wild? Actually, the killer whales in the wild are much different from what they like in the aquariums. In the wild, they distribute in almost every state area from the equator to the polar region. Now you can look at the yellow area in this map. They are not limited by the climate, temperature, and the depth of the ocean. They are 8 meters long and have 40 tubes. They don't have enemies. They go hunting together, cleverly and cruelly, just like great hunters. They have their own society and culture. They are the sons of the sea and the kings of the ocean. Now you can see, there are many differences between the killer whales in the wild and in the ocean. In the wild and in the aquariums, some people don't care how different the killer whales are in the aquariums and in the wild. They don't care the feelings of the killer whales. They only want to make money and have fun from the sea animals. So they catch the killer whales and treat them like pets, or even I can see, like slaves. They think they are the managers. They can manage everything. It lasted until that bloody event happened. In 2010, the killer whale killed its trainer during its show in an aquarium in California. It attacked its trainer and pulled her into the water. This bloody event made a big impact. People find the killer whale had killed two people before this event. People began to think the feelings of the killer whales and find cruel facts about the aquariums. The killer whale who killed three people was cut from the ocean when it was a child. It was away from its home, the ocean, and family, was abused. It was often hit, not fed, stay in a very small space, and was attacked by the other killer whales. It bear the pain, the hunger, and the loneliness. Don't forget, it's the sound of the sea, the symbol of the freedom, and was guessed to have the same IQ as the over 10 years old human child. How can he bear it? Of course, he cannot. He got a many depressive psychosis, and finally, he chose to kill. He revenged cleverly and made a big impact. It was just like he told everyone he cannot become sure by the human. People began to find the cruel facts about the aquariums, and it was how harmful to see animals. What's the most important was that people find they cannot control the killer whale. They were silly to think they have the power and the right to control the natural. To sum up, what I want to say is people cannot catch and treat the killer whales, not only because we cannot control them. They might hurt or even kill people's life, but also we should respect the natural. We have our duty. If we cannot protect the natural whale, at least we should not hurt the creatures. Killer whale is a special creature. It has emotion and feelings. It might get melancholia if it lost freedom. So we should have a soft place in our hearts and think what the killer whales think. In this way, not only we protect ourselves, not only we protect killer whale, we protect ourselves. So, and also, we can teach our children to love and to be kind to nature.